Hello everyone, today I am talking about the new update to Killing Floor 2, the Incinerate and Detonate Pack. This is a free DLC, it's really just an update to the game. It adds 50% more content over what there was before. It is a 4GB patch that downloads over Steam. It just installs and you play it. So, let's get into the actual new stuff. There's two new maps. Main stuff, at least. Two new maps. There's Catacombs and there's Evacuation Point. I have both on here. There's new perks. There's Firebug and Demolitions. I have both on here. But then also, Berserker has been completely reworked. I do not play as Berserker in this, but if Berserker is a class that interests you, it'll be changed a lot. There's new weapons. There's the Caulk and Bird, the Dragon's Breath Trench Gun, the Microwave Gun, the Molotov Cocktail, Firebug Fireman's Blade, 8x25 Grenade Pistol, C4 Remote Detonated Explosive, M79 Grenade Launcher, RPG-7, Dynamite, Demo Utility Knife, Dual 9mm, and Zwei Honda. So, I use a few of the new weapons in this. What I play is Firebug and Demolitions. A few of them are very interesting. The Microwave Gun is interesting. It is a top tier weapon, but it didn't seem as effective as it could be when I used it on this. Anyways, the demo does exactly as advertised, and it blows shit up. There's two new characters. There's Anton Strasser, which is unlocked by owning Red Orchestra 2/Rising Storm, Tom Banner, and it's unlocked by owning Chivalry. So two new characters that involve owning other games. I play as Strasser in this one. They both have custom voice packs, it would seem. There's some new features. Zeds now have normal, resistant, and weakness zones via damage type on skin. So this means you shoot them in different spots, and it does different damage. At least that's how I interpreted it. There's an after-action report that has many detailed stats at the end of the match. It has awards and stuff like that. Each player's statistics for the game. It has kick voting, fucking finally, map voting, so you can now vote on maps at the end of a round. Dual wielding, 9mm being the first weapons for this, just like Killing Floor 1, and if you ask me, the dual-wielding 9mm is much better now, because it actually aims down the sights of one, so you can see where you're aiming, if you don't know where the center of your screen is. Sorry I'm sick, everyone. I'm sure that you've noticed this in my last couple videos. NVIDIA's Physics Flex technology for NVIDIA GeForce 770s and above. Not exactly sure what that is. Could Google it if you're interested in that. Killed by messages. It now says who you were killed by, as in which Zed killed you. Ability to equip multiple cosmetics per character, so you can equip different things on one character. Shared content system. This is a very interesting thing. If one player has a weapon, everyone else on the server has access to it. So if someone connects, they have a DLC weapon pack, everyone on the server has access to it. So there won't be as much of a need to buy DLC. And last feature is NVIDIA GeForce Experience integration. I use the GeForce Experience. I'm not exactly sure what the integration is. I didn't notice any big changes. So there's lots of general improvements and additions. I will say I noticed the game running better, much better, and you can see in the video how it ran. I noticed a few things with stuttering still, but of course it's not released yet. My thoughts on the new stuff. On the new maps, Catacombs is a really intense map. It's the first map I have in here. I have either 5 to 10 minutes of it. Not sure, because I'm recording the voice before I put the video in. And it's a very easy map to get split up in and end up running around fucking terrified. Because if you watch all the way to the end of it, you'll see me getting chased by the boss. I forget his name. It's not the Patriarch, but the boss chases you and That's pretty terrifying because it's catacombs. It's not an organized map like usual. The other map, Evacuation Point, unfortunately was only played with one other person, so I didn't get to experience it completely, but I really like the style of it. And of course, they can add more to the maps or they can change them still since the game is still in beta. I like the new maps though. Firebug and Demolitions. I really enjoy Firebug. Demolitions is pretty fun too. Lots of explosions. The only thing I could complain about would be the ammo limitations with both classes, but that's to be expected with this game. So I guess it's actually working as intended. The new weapons, I tested the Kalkin Bird, Microwave Gun, and the Flamethrower. They all work pretty well. The Microwave Gun's just weird because it's not a normal fire weapon. The grenade weapons for Demolition. The grenade pistol does okay-ish damage. The M79 grenade launcher is a grenade launcher, does grenade damage. The RPG-7 will fuck your shit up. It's that simple. So, I have Firebug on Catacombs first, and then Demolitions on Evacuation Point. I'm gonna have about 10 minutes of each, so please watch the video. And, well, you're already watching the video, so please like, share, subscribe. If you have any more questions about Killing Floor 2, leave them below. I'll answer them to the best of my ability. And if you like zombie games, check this game out because it's pretty fun. It's still early access, so that's my warning. It's early access. You might want to wait till it completely comes out, but either way, it's fun. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.
Everyone healthy. Reloading. I just saw a shimmer. Something close.
Spin freely. Things are about to get serious.
I need resupply. Hit what you aim at then. Is anyone wounded?
Bring up the trading controls and upgrade your gear.
Anyone of those new neurons. Stay focused. My enemies are most dangerous when close to defeat.
Don't underestimate the enemy. One mistake, you're all dead. Here's money. Buy nice marks for you, my friend.
Some marks.
Final choices, people. Enemies on the scope.
Women, money. Get one woman, man. Not the best nurse.
Much better.
Time's almost up. Wait.
Give your weapons and ammo.
Bonjour. Come and get your tools of trade.
You have been killing my test subjects. That is annoying. You will die now.
Anyone hurt?
Good, danke.
Thank you.
in for some fresh meat here. I'll work just like in Stalingrad, fools. The stench of your infant eye. Let me test my new nerve gas. Defeat is inevitable.
On the way.
Choices.
We got ammo?
You earn the money. Now spend it. I'm about to shut the pod.
I'm poor and I'm risking my life. Nothing changes.
Break time's over. Get back to work. More Zeds inbound.
Ammo,
Reloading!
Everyone alive?
You've dented their numbers, but there are plenty left. Off, so I can open the trader pod for you. Perfect. Pod is open again. Let's get you restocked.
Stay focused. Our enemies are most dangerous when close to defeat.
Zed's on the way. Start to wrap things up, as they say. Glad you made it back. Don't bleed on anything. Bonjour. Come and get your tools of trade. Hurry up. Zed's are getting closer. You earned the money. Now spend it. More Zeds on the scope. Back to it, mes amis.
They're working well together so far.
Finish the job. Allez.
They did, what's it?
Scheiße!
Watch out! Something is close!
Batch out. Nice work. We can reopen the trader pod soon.
Nice! Oh, scheiße!
Screamer.
pod for resupply.
Yourselves.
A decent beginning. Let's call that your warm-up. Your gear.
We all got enough ammunition?
Ammo's good.
You earned the money. Now spend it.
Good. I'm healed.
Choices, people. Enemies on the scope.
Now the M79. Ammo.
Last chance. I have to power down the pod. Zed's on the scope. Back to it, mes amis.
Is anyone wounded?
Good.
Out. Nice work. We can reopen the trader pod soon.
Scheiße!
Did you move?
Perfect. Pod is open again. Let's get you restocked. Bring up the trading controls and upgrade your gear.
So much blood.
We're almost out of time. Make your choices. Glad you made it back. Don't bleed on anything.
Warrior will always...
Hurry up. Zeds are getting closer. Closed. Go make a difference.
Everyone alive?
Good, danke.
Good start. Now finish the job. Allez. You'll be cut into pieces if someone doesn't heal your team.
Weapon here.
Bring up the trading controls and upgrade your gear. Go heal your teammates.